Here's a question. Who is Facebook's biggest competitor?
Well, when you look at a list of the most popular social media apps in the US, this is what it looks like. On top, you have Facebook. But of course, it's not just Facebook that Mark Zuckerberg owns. It's Facebook Messenger, it's Instagram, it's WhatsApp.
When you combine those companies up, Facebook's dominance is clear. And one big reason for that is that Facebook has shown that it knows how to stop an emerging competitor right in its tracks. And this is how it does it. If Facebook sees a competitor on the horizon, it's likely gonna do one of these three things: buy, deny, or apply. Now let's go through them one by one. The first one, buy. Facebook has spent billions of dollars buying up companies, and the two most important acquisitions were two of its biggest emerging competitors. Instagram went for $1 billion in 2012, and 2 years later, WhatsApp went for $22 billion. Now, at the time, people questioned how WhatsApp could possibly be worth that much money, $22 billion. This was an app that has no ads and charged its users less than a dollar a year. They don't even charge that much anymore. Well, WhatsApp alone will probably never make Facebook that money back in terms of pure revenue. But Facebook clearly thought that getting rid of a fast-growing competitor was worth billions of dollars. Now, option two, when buying doesn't work, Facebook can deny, as in deny access to its data. Whenever you sign up for a site and use your Facebook login, that's because Facebook opens up its platform and gives other apps access to its data. It's called an API. But Facebook's API also gives it power. The day that Twitter launched Vine, Facebook took action to restrict Vine's access to Facebook's data right away. Mark Zuckerberg himself approved cutting off Vine's ability to let users invite their Facebook friends to join the app. That's according to emails that were recently released by the UK Parliament. And Vine wasn't the only one that this happened to. Other companies that Facebook saw as competitors discovered one day that Facebook had cut off their access to its APIs. And many of those companies don't exist anymore. The day before the emails were released, Facebook backtracked on the policy, and now it says that it won't cut off companies from its API anymore. Now, option number three. If buying or denying doesn't work, then in comes apply, as in copy and apply. Take Snapchat. Facebook reportedly tried to buy Snapchat for $3 billion, but that didn't work. Snapchat turned them down. So instead, Mark Zuckerberg just copied what Snapchat did best. Because Facebook took its core functionalities, Snapchat has never really fully recovered.
Shares of Snap tumbling big this morning, down more than 6% as Snapchat's daily user base declined for the first time.
So Facebook has protected its market share by using this variety of tactics, from buying up companies, from denying others access to its data, and then copying and applying core features from other apps. All that has amounted to a brilliant business strategy, but now it could spell serious trouble for Facebook. That's because regulators, politicians, and advocates are now speaking up about Facebook's business practices, and an antitrust case could be on the horizon. So now, it's not just competitors that Facebook has to worry about.